how many of the streets of West Jerusalem look right now. Traffic has been completely blocked off. Thousands and thousands of ultra-Orthodox Jews have come out for a prayer that is also a protest against government plans to draft more young men from their community into the army. The cabinet already agreed last year that it was going to end an exemption for tens of thousands of yeshiva students. These are religious seminaries where ultra-Orthodox Jews study. And now there is proposed legislation that would see a quota for the number of ultra-Orthodox Jews entering the military or else doing civilian public service. Many here feel that their religious lifestyle is under attack.
Their lifestyle is waking up in the morning, going to synagogue, going to pray. That's all it is. Praying and learning, that's all it is. There's nothing past that, and doing the commandments, and that's the end of it. And doing this, going to the army, is not going to be the right thing at all.
We were brought up in a different way than that. We're brought up in a way that, you know, we strictly, our service is to God, and we split up into two sections. If you're fit enough to go to the army, go to the army. If you're fit to serve our God and to help with the army in that way, that's what we do.
But for many in Israel's secular majority, changing the law and ending the exemption is about ending an historic injustice and sharing a social burden. When the State of Israel was created in 1948, ultra-Orthodox Jews made up just a tiny percentage of society. But now, because of their high birth rate, they account for about 10% of Israel's population.